If you've ever had the need to drill a bunch of really straight holes, or a bunch of holes that are of the exact same depth, or a bunch of holes, really, or if you've ever just wanted a drill press, this is your opportunity to...
What, give away a free drill press?
All right, so drill press layouts are roughly the same going from machine to machine. So whatever we say here probably applies to the machine that you're working on as well. All right, so as a rough overview, you've got your head of the drill, which is like this chunk of stuff here. You've got the table, you've got the base, and then the column in the back. You've got your typical start and stop button. So the start button starts the machine, and the stop button stops the machine. This setup here is gonna be where what holds your bit in, the spindle and the chuck, which is in. Then this is a stop block, which can set the depth of cut, like customize the depth of the cut that you're making. And then this is the spoil cover, spoil block. So if you're using a vise that's just being placed, or a clamp just being placed here, and you're not using the T-slot hardware, then you're gonna wanna keep this piece of like protection wood, the soil layer. Say you don't have T-slot hardware, or you're being lazy, which you shouldn't be, but sometimes with a heavy vise, it can usually be okay. Always make sure that the handle is pointing this way, because the drill bit spins this way, so if it jerks your piece, it'll jerk it that way, and this will hit the column and not your tummy, because columns are more replaceable than tummies, and also the column can take it. So if you think about it, if it's on this side, it spins and it catches, it'll come around and it'll hit you, right, like you're standing here, and it'll hit you in the stomach, and that would be a really, really bad day. And then you have your vertical adjustment here, and this is how you actually do your drilling. One thing you might need to do is set the depth of the cut. So with that, you can use this, and you unscrew one of them, and then chase it down with the other one. And that will put a limit to the depth of your cut. So that means you can get kind of repeatability in cut depth. So inside of here, you have your pulleys and your belts, and this will change the speed. If you want to, you can loosen. There's generally a screw on each side of your drill press. And then use this handle to adjust. So right now I'm detensioning it so that I can potentially change the speed using these belts. So in every drill press, like ever, there are these two charts here to make sure you don't F it up. And so you have your speed chart, and then you have your like setup chart. So over here, so take for example, if I'm trying to cut a quarter inch hole in a piece of steel, I go to my speed chart and I say steel, I go to quarter inch hole, and then I go look at the speed, and that's 1150. So then I go over here and I'm like, okay, well, how do I do 1150? There's a chart right here, and so it is the top one on the left and the second to top one on the right. So you do the top one on the left and the second to top one here on the right. All right, so to put a drill bit into this, if you're new to this, I actually find the easiest way to do it is you make it so it's a little bit too small, like that, and then you widen it until it slips in like that. So you don't end up with something like this. And this is obviously accentuated for the camera, but this is super common if you have the bit only in two of these. See, it's only in these two right here, rather than being nicely snug in all. And a good way to check is actually if you turn it on and it's nice and straight. Once you have your bit nicely in here, and you want to make sure that your cutting edges are not in the chuck. So you can see I just barely didn't make it in. So make sure that your cutting edge is not inside of the chuck. Once this is nicely in here, you want to grab your key, which is going to look something like this. Grip it there, and that should be tight enough. If you can't really undo it by hand, then you're all set. All right, to adjust this table, you want to loosen the lock on the adjustment so that it's kind of freely swinging. And then you can use this crank to make it lower or to make it higher. While this is loosened, and only while this is loosened, you can also rotate the table so that you can make sure your hole is in the right place. This is a fairly big piece, and many of you are going to be drilling pieces that are bigger than this. It might look like you can hold it with your fingers, and if I can impart any knowledge on you today, don't do it. It is so worth grabbing a vise, grabbing some T-slot hardware, grabbing something to make sure that you're not, first of all, you don't want to put your fingers in this realm. Second of all, this is steel, or any kind of metal you're working with is going to get hot. And third of all, it's just not safe. So make sure to clamp it down in some way. I'm not going to judge your like clamping. Just do it. Nike swoosh. Whoosha. So you want to raise the table to make sure it's about an inch or so from the bit. And then I'm going to rotate the table so that the piece is actually under it and in the right spot. Actually, right there seems about right. So this is your best friend. This is your lubricant for the shop. So Tap Magic, lube, whatever you want to call it. It does a lot of really important things, like make sure you're not frying your part, you're not don't really want to grind something down without lubricating it. It's a coolant. It'll make sure a lot of bad things happen. Just note that if you use a lot of it, it's totally fine, but you're going to get a little bit of smoke, and that is normal. So don't, just ignore it. Okay, you want to lubricate your workpiece, and you also want to lubricate your bit. To go, just hit start. Bring it down, and you want to just and after you do any cuts, you want to brush away the shavings and the extra lubricant. So, and that is what it looks like now. All right, so that's like your mini drill press tutorial. Hopefully you found that helpful. Seriously, the drill press is a really easy tool, a really easy machine. It's like a watered down mill, honestly. So have fun, build cool things, and let us know what you're doing in the comments below. Thanks.